But right now, we are going to talk about the fighting game genre. And first of all, let's take a look at this trailer.
Soul Edge, a legendary sword and devourer of souls. Transcending history and the world, a tale of souls and swords eternally retold.
Show me what you've got.
Head there if you seek Soul Edge.
But I never back down from a challenge.
I like that.
I'm choosing not to back down.
Fate is carved with your own hands.
No human can bear that
power. We will get our revenge.
Yes, pain does indeed lie in the past.
Mother, I am ready.
Soul Edge is more powerful than ever before.
Fate has chosen.
I'll carve my own fate!
All right, that's Soul Calibur 6 coming later this year, but right now it is my great honor to introduce two gentlemen who have a huge hand in Tekken, Soul Calibur, and many things from Bandai Namco on the fighting spectrum. Please welcome Harada-san and Okubo-san. Well, good to see you. Good to see you, Matt. That's everything. All right. Well, guys, welcome to E3. Thanks for joining us here at the E3 Coliseum. And this is our fighting game dojo panel, where we're going to talk a lot about the fighting game genre, and certainly it's genre that is very close to the heart of both of you guys. So my first question to both of you is, how has the fighting game genre changed over your careers? Because in many ways, fighting is one of those genres where, you know, it's still a very similar style of gameplay, but there's been so much depth to these games that's been added over time. How has it changed?
So, ,あの... 一番でかいのはやっぱりこう時代の変遷というかやっぱりこうファイティングゲームとしてのすごいブームがあってでそのブームの後にまあジャンルとしての定着があったんですけどそれと同時に特にアメリカとかヨーロッパからはアーケードシーンというのがドーンと一回なくなってでその後ちょうどオンラインのインフラがまだみんなの世界にあまり整ってない時代かつアーケードがないという時代になって時に結構いろんな格闘ゲームっていうのがタイトルが姿をバーッと消してしまってで、まあ、鉄拳は結構コンスタントに出してしっかり売れてきたんですけどその後ようやくオンラインの時代が来て新時代が来て今はどっちかっていうと結構コミュニティベースの e スポーツの時代っていう形でかなり大きく変わってきているというのは僕のファイティングゲームに対しての認識ですね。
Well, you know, first there was the boom in, that actually created the genre in fighting games. You had a lot of titles. Then it started first in the arcade, as many fighting games did.
Yep.
But then for Europe and America, you saw the decline in the arcade scene. And it was at a time when there wasn't the network infrastructure yet, so there wasn't this online play that you had in the past, in that you have now. So there was that gap between the two where you saw a lot of games actually drop off the scene and you don't see them that much. And then you had the advent of the online infrastructure, online play, which helped the genre and it kind of shifted in that direction. And then now you have esports kind of being a major part of the fighting game scene.
Yeah. For you guys, what's your vision of sort of where the fighting games will go in the future?
Future.
Yeah.
Future. 私自身は原田さんと違ってまだまだ家庭用のプロデューサーって経験が浅いので、まあ、先ほどの質問も含めてお返事させていただくと、やっぱりここまでいろんな格闘ゲームも出てきている中でこのあと我々もどんどん格闘ゲームを出していきたいんですけれども鉄拳は鉄拳なりのターゲットに向けて、しっかりと打ち出していく。それは多分 e スポーツ っていうキーワードを軸にやっぱり考えていくところは多分にあると思いますし、ソウルカリバーはソウルキャリバーらしい、剣撃の格闘っていうところで、ドラゴンボールはドラゴンボールで、やっぱり あれはあれでそのジャンルの中での格闘っていうところで、どんどんどんそっちの方向で広げていければなというふうには思ってます。
I think each game kind of has its own place and role in、the fighting game genre, and unlike Mr. Hart, I don't have as much experience developing for a console, unfortunately, but I think the future of games、for example, you take、Tekken, and that has its own very fist fighting type of fighting action, and then Soul Calibur fills a different role where you're fighting with weapons, and Dragon Ball is its ownthing completely. So all three of these titles are going to kind of carry a torch and spread the love for fighting games in different directions. I think that's kind of where the future is headed.
まあ僕はあれですね、どっちかというとちょっと全体の話で言うと、もうちょっと格闘ゲームには技術的革新は、入れていく必要があるだろうなと思ってて、それはもうゲームのタイトルはそれぞれ皆さんの本当好きなものでいいと思うんですけど、まあ、例えば AI をもうちょっと駆使してまあ、マッチングとかですよね。やっぱり同じような腕前の人をしっかりマッチングさせる技術だとか、まあ、もしくはゲームを学ぶのに、あらかじめ用意された仕組みだけじゃなくて、もう AI、クラウドの AI からこの自分に合ったトレーニングの仕方とかっていう形でゲームへの導入がないと、ちょっと、今のままこうローカルに入っているデータだけで、いろんなことをやっていくっていうのはユーザーへのサービスとしてちょっと足りてないなというふうに思ってるんで、未来はちょっとその AI とかの技術の革新が必要だと思ってます。
I think in the future there's a need to introduce new technology to the genre, not necessarily for all fighting games, you know, each can do their own thing that is their specialty and what they want to pursue. But I'm quite kind of interested in the use of AI, for example,to help match you with an opponent that is at an equal level so you enjoy the game more, or not just fighting against the CPU to train yourself and get better at the game, but to actually find kind of like the, from the cloud, an AI opponent that is suited to that particular thing that you need to practice more. Something like that to kind of bolster the experience, I think, is something that would help the consumer experience.
Yeah.I know obviously Soul Calibur is a focus here at E3, but I think everyone's wondering where Tekken may go in the future. Harada-san, anything you can tell us about where you would like to see, you know, Tekken go in the future?
そうですね、かなり鉄拳もやっぱ長くやってきて、一番必要なのはこう経験上ですけど、やっぱりある程度こう客層が横に広がるのもすごいいろんなね、お客さんの層に広がっていくっていうのもすごく重要なんですが、それは割とできてきてるんですけど、世代交代っていうところはやっぱりとても難しくて、ゲーム自体の、リフレッシュっていうのと、コミュニティ自体のやっぱり今やってる人たちが卒業しても新しい若い人たちがやっていくっていうところを、こうなんとか鉄拳でうまくこういう見せ方があるよ、やり方があるよっていうのを示していきたいなというふうには思ってるんですけど、とても僕の脳みそもだいぶ年を取ってきたので、ちょっと僕自体がもう交代して新しい世代の人が作っていくゲームにしなきゃいけないんじゃないかなというふうに今は思ってますけどね。
Well, you know, it's tough when you're creating a fighting game. There's many things that you have to achieve. One is, you know, broadening the audience and having different segments, which I think we've succeeded with over the years of developing Tekken. But at the same time, you have to get a new audience to adopt the game as well.As your current audience grows and gets older, they kind of leave and do other things. So I think we need to focus more on attracting a younger audience who will continue to play the game for years to come. How to do that is something that's kind of difficult for me, since I'm kind of old myself. So maybe not just refresh the game and the audience, but refresh the people who make it as well might be one approach.
All right, well, we can't wait to see... who you work with and what happens in the future of Tekken. But obviously this year is about Soul Calibur. Akuma-san, tell us a bit about your vision for Soul Calibur. It was great to have you announce it at the Game Awards last December, which everyone was very excited, and revealing more about the game here at E3, showing playable content. What are you hoping to add to the fighting game genre with SC6?
格ゲージャンルに何を追加したいかと、まあソウルキャリバーを通して、
ソウルキャリバーを通して、鉄拳7のプロデューサーも 家庭用のプロデューサーも実は務めさせていただいてるんですけど、ソウルキャリバーはやっぱり武器を持って戦う意味、武器を自由に振り回す気持ちよさ、それから8ウェイランに代表される自由にこうステージの中を移動できる気持ちよさで、武器を持ってますので、その武器の特徴、間合いっていうところですね、それで相手と戦うっていうところの中のやはり非常に独特でユニークな格闘ゲームだと思いますので、そこの部分をしっかりと突き詰めたいなというふうに思ってます。
I had the fortunate position of seeing, I helped with the production of Tekken 7 as well, so I got to see it from both sides. And I think Soul Calibur fills a unique role in the fighting game genre. And because it's all about the weapons, it's very driven by the weapons that each character wields. So whether it's the type of weapon that your character is wielding, or it's the spacing or the distance or the eight-way run mechanic, which I think is unique to Soul Calibur, it fills a very different role than what Tekken does.
Yeah. Esports is something you mentioned, Harada, as you know, bringing new life into the world of fighting games, especially with Evo and other competitions. How do you think esports will change the popularity of fighting games? It feels like there is this sort of resurgence now in fighting games, certainly on a year-round basis with competition. Maybe you could both comment on esports, fighting games, and how that's going to sort of feed off of each other in a way.
まあ、その原さんが言った世代交代に e スポーツがちょうど貢献してるんじゃないかなと思うんだけど、まあ、あのジェフさんから見てもちょっと人が入ってきた印象があるので、まあ、どうやってさらにその加熱して、格ゲーの人気を上げる役割になるのかという e スポーツに関して、
そうですね、一つ間違いなく言えることは e スポーツってキーワードが結構こうバズワードとして世の中を今騒がせる以前からファイティングゲームコミュニティっていうのがやっぱり非常に強くもう日本でもアジアでももう世界中であって、で特にやっぱ近年はこの欧米のあのファイティングゲームコミュニティがこの e スポーツシーンっていうのを実際ファイティングゲームに対してはすごく作ってくれている。だから我々が作ったシーンというよりかはゲームは我々作ってるんですけど、コミュニティはあくまで、この e スポーツの下支えとして盛り上げてくれたっていうのがあるので、結構我々から何か仕掛けたっていうことがまだ、花開いてるわけではないんですね。だからどちらかというとこれからはそのコミュニティのフィードバックっていうのがゲームの仕様だとか、ゲームの中身、面白さ、競技の面白さっていうところに反映されていくので、でようやくそのターンが始まるのかなと僕はまだまだこれはまだ始まりに過ぎないと思ってるので、今度はゲームの中にそういうさっき言った e スポーツの要素、コミュニティからの要望っていうのがたくさん反映される時代が来るっていうふうに僕は思っています。はい。
Well, you know, it's interesting that e-sports is such a widely known term now, but fighting games have had their own kind of competitive scene before e-sports was even a keyword. So this is something that our community has been doing for quite some time, not only in Japan and Asia, but worldwide. And it just so happened that we didn't really create e-sports. It was something that the community was doing, and they're the base of what is now e-sports. So a lot of the things that we're planning for esports is something that started after that, yeah. And that we'll continue to see the effects of from now into the future. Obviously, it's many, many things. Some of it is watching how people are enjoying your game and adjusting the spec of your game to kind of help it do even better in the esports environment. Yeah. But we have to remember that it's not something we made. It's something that came from the community.
Absolutely.
2日前にジェフさんにも同じことを話したんですけど、e スポーツのためにゲームを、作ってるっていうふうにしちゃうとちょっとやっぱり違うと思うんですね。僕たちとしては、面白い楽しいゲームをお客様に提供して、でコミュニティが e スポーツの中でソウルキャリバー6とかを、まずサポートしてもらえればいいんじゃないかなというふうに思います。で今原田さんが言ってたように、ただ、その e スポーツをより促進させるためにゲーム側でできることってまだまだあると思いますので、まあ、そういったものは少しずつでもですね、取り組んでいければなというふうには思いますね。
I think when we develop games, we want, our first priority is to develop a game that's fun and engaging, and it is very fortunate that the esports community takes that into their repertoire and plays the game. But like Mr. Harada-san said, I think there's going to be this sort of two-way dialogue that's going to start happening, so we're going to be listening to the community, what the esports scene needs in the game, and then start making some adjustments from there.
Yeah. You know, there are a couple developers around the world that are known for making great fighting games, and you know, we always hear from you guys, what's NetherRealm or what's happening now, you know, Smash and the collaboration even there with Bandai Namco, which was a big morning if you're a Smash fan, for all that they announced. What do you guys attribute to sort of the secret sauce of Bandai Namco and your developers? Why are you guys so good at fighting games? Obviously, it's a big focus, but what do you think makes, you know, your teams unique and so well equipped to build these fighting games?
まあ、我々がそこまで本当にね、全てできてるかっていうと、多分今でこそスマッシュブラザーズの開発だとかポッケの開発任せてもらったりとか、そういうグループにはなっていますけど、 結構大きかった学びは、やっぱりアーケードがあった時代っていうのはすごく大きくて、あれが世界中にあった時はみんなの遊び方っていうのをすごく見れたんですね。で、ある時からそれをちゃんとこう大きいビッグデータ化しよう、今ビッグデータってキーワード当たり前になってますけど、 90年代当時、21世紀の初頭はまだまだそういう統計的な物事の考え方っていうのがなかった時代なんですけど、その時に結構我々早めに ストリートファイターとかバーチャファイターに追いつきたくて、結構そこら辺のデータを顧客データ集めて、そこからやっぱニーズとか面白さみたいなところがどこにあるかっていうのを早めに言語化できてたっていうのはかなり大きかったと思いますけどね。
Well, I'm not sure that if we're, you know, exactly doing everything perfectly regarding fighting games in the genre, etc. Although it is true that we have experience, and games like Smash Brothers and Pokken have actually allowed us to be part of the development on those titles. But I can say that the origin is probably our development experience we had in the past in the arcade, not only in Japan, but worldwide, was a good opportunity for us to see how the players are enjoying our games. And this is before, you know, now you have the trendy word of big data where people try to collect all these things. But there wasn't such a thing back then. So it was all just watching directly, or even later on when we could gather from the arcades, et cetera. Yeah. We were trying to, as far as Tekken goes, catch up to Street Fighter and Virtua Fighter at the time. So that was one of the things that we actually heavily focused on, was kind of collecting this data and putting it into a certain plan about this is how they're playing our games, so this is how we should deliver it to them.
Wow. Well, it's certainly an amazing legacy that you guys have built. And of course, there are new games that sometimes enter the fray. I wanted to ask you both, Dragon Ball FighterZ, what's your perspective on that game?
非常に今うちから出させていただいている格闘ゲームが、鉄拳で、ドラゴンボールファイターズ両方ともおかげさまで非常にあのいい評価をいただいてまして、やっぱり格闘ゲーム自体がやっぱ冬の時代よく言われる冬の時代みたいなのもあって、まあその時々によってやっぱりあの見られ方が変わってくると思うんですけど、まあうちの会社で言うと、鉄拳も売れたし、ドラゴンボールもファイターズも売れたし、ソウルキャリバーは当然売れるんだよねということで非常に大きなプレッシャーを感じています。
I think, you know, we're very fortunate to be able to work on games like Tekken and Fighters. And I think there's this kind of wave, if you will, in the fighting game scene. And things are going to come and go. And those Tekken and Dragon Ball have been really highly rated by the community. And you see it in esports scenes as well. But what's happening more internally for me, actually, is that, you know, Tekken did really well. And Dragon Ball Fighters obviously did really well. So it begs the question, how is Soul Calibur 6 going to do? So I'm feeling a lot of pressure right now.
It's a lot, yeah. Well, it's a great honor, I know, for you to be working on SC6. Tell us a bit about E3 here. What can we expect to play? I know we had you on the YouTube show the other day and showed off some of the gameplay, special guest character that most people probably know who it is. But tell us, what is that E3 for Soul Calibur?
今回の E3 向けに、ハンズオンのビルドをあの
出させていただいております。ここまで発表した、まあ、ゲストは、ウィッチャーからのゲラルトですね。でそちらの方も遊べますし、ここまで発表した新キャラクターのグローであったりとか、おなじみのキャラクターもいろいろ使えますので、ぜひ、E3 の会場で近くにありますので、hands-on で遊んでみてもらえればなと思います。
I think the biggest thing for Soul Calibur to happen at E3 is going to be the hands-on playable demo, which you can, I encourage all of you to go check out at our booth. We introduced the Geralt from The Witcher. He's going to be playable as well as Gro, the new character we just added. So those are all going to be playable, and I think we're really proud of how they came out.
Excellent. Yeah, we will definitely be over there playing it. Now, as you guys think of the future of your teams, as we all get older, you think of the next generation of developers. Can you maybe talk about how you are cultivating or grooming or preparing a new generation of creators? And certainly, you know, with Akubo-san taking over Soul Calibur, that's one thing. But as you look at Harada for the other teams, and you mentioned this before about finding new folks to breathe new life into Tekken, where do you think where's that going to come from? Will it come from developers within, or may it be a collaboration with other studios too?
Yeah, so Okubo-san が新しくキャリバーをやり始めて、で、さっきのコメントから、じゃあ内部から人を交代とかもしくは増やすのか、それとも外部の会社を使ってこう新しい人を入れる
か、コラボレーションしたりとかして作る。難しいですね。やっぱりコミュニティにもそうですし、デベロップのチームにもそうですし、やっぱ新しい地っていうのは必ず必要だと僕は思ってるので、僕はもうどんどん自分若い世代ができることをどんどん渡していってるんですけど、結構新しい今のあるスタジオのコアのチームと別のこうスタジオが作る、もしくは例えば欧米の会社にグラフィックのアセットとか描画の見せ方とか、そういうのを逆にアメリカの会社にやってもらうっていうのは結構面白いことが起きるんじゃないかなと個人的には思ってます。難易度は高いと思いますけど。
Well, you know, I've been already kind of handing off a lot of tasks to some of the younger people on my team. We have the core team in the studio in Japan, so I don't think that will change in the future. But something that could be considered is perhaps to partner up with an American company to do maybe some of the graphic assets or the presentation of the game. Trying something like that might be a way to make it more fresh, but at the same time keep that core essence.
Yeah, well, we will see what happens with the future games. For wrapping this up here, I was wondering if you guys have anything you want the fans to know about your games and your approach to fighting games and where it's going to go in the future.
まあ格闘ゲームの将来というよりかは今本当にソウルキャリバー6開発終盤で必死で作っています。でようやくですね。今日午前中に発売日10月19日ということでアナウンスさせていただきました。ストーリーモードの、ね、トレーラー先ほど流れましたけど、そちらの方も公開させていただきました。まだまだこれから、アナウンスしていくこといっぱいありますし、まあ、10月19日ってすごく混み合ってる時期なんですけれども、どうしてもギリギリまでやっぱり調整とか開発したかったんで、まあ、逆に言うと正々堂々と自信を持って出せますので、ぜひお楽しみにしててください。
Well, I think the future of fighting games is a very broad scope, but thankfully we were able to announce the release date for Soul Calibur 6, and I know the team right now is in the dungeon finishing up all the development. Yeah. So it's coming out in October, later in October, and I had to negotiate with my bosses to give my team as much time possible to give it that last coat of polish. So we've got a great story mode and a great game coming up.
そうですね、格闘ゲームっていうのがやっぱり今カメラが横から見てヘッドトゥヘッド、かつ、まあ、例えば人によっては1対1じゃないと格闘ゲームじゃないっていう人もいる中で、少しずつでもこの e スポーツのシーン含めて、その格闘ゲームっていう競技性の意味で解釈も広がっているし、ゲームのジャンルとしてももう少し、必ずしもこう横からのヘッドトゥヘッドじゃないものも生まれてきて、それが未来には格闘ゲームだっていうふうに同じく呼ばれているような 時代が来るともう少しちょっと表現の幅とか、遊びの幅っていうのが広がるかなと僕は思うので、そういうチャレンジはちょっとうちの会社でもやっていきたいなというふうに思ってます。
あと最後のアピールだから、うん、その鉄拳
あそうね、鉄拳今ねちょうど、鉄拳もおかげさまでかなりもう売れて、いろいろサポートしてるんですけど、まだまだ実はこれから続けてちょっとサプライズとかも用意してますので、そこは期待しててほしいですね。
So, you know, for the future of moving forward with fighting games, I think that everyone has this stuck in their head that a fighting game is one-on-one, you know, viewing the game screen from the side, etc. But, you know, does it really have to be only one person against the other? There's many things about the genre that we could perhaps change while still kind of keeping that competitive element. So that's something that I would like to kind of look at as far as how we could challenge those ideas. And then, you know, for Tekken, the game has done quite well, Tekken 7 that is, and we're still right in the middle of the Tekken World Tour, so there's a lot of new stuff coming up to look forward to, and we hope everyone will stay tuned.
Awesome. All right. Well, congratulations on a big E3 for Soul Calibur. Look forward to hearing what you're doing in the future, and thanks for joining us. Stick around here at E3 Coliseum. We've got Hideo Kojima coming up, Todd Howard, Grim Fandango, Elijah Wood, and so much more on day one of the Coliseum. Thanks, guys. We'll be right back.